Hello everyone! Friends, I have some shocking news for you. Right now, while you're watching this video, you're evolving. And not only because you're about to learn something new and interesting, but because there is scientific evidence that human evolution is still going on. What's more, you and I are far from the top of the evolutionary chain, but in the middle at best. And I'll prove it to you. Let's go! Fact number one, we drink milk. Milk and dairy products contain lactose, and the gene that regulates lactose digestion in humans came about as a result of evolution. Originally, humans could only digest their mother's milk and only as infants. But long ago, people domesticated cows, goats, and sheep, and the human body began to produce a hormone that helps break down lactose. Right now, only 25% of people in the world can digest lactose. Get this! Here you are drinking milk or eating cheese, and you have no idea how unique you are and what results you have achieved in your evolutionary development. By the way, most of those who don't have this hormone are people from Africa and South America. Some of them cannot tolerate lactose since childhood, and some of them stopped producing the hormone as adults. Fact number two, many people never grow wisdom teeth. The diet of ancient man consisted mostly of roots, leaves, and nuts. This caused teeth to wear out rather quickly. Wisdom teeth are an evolutionary response to this problem. They were stored in the mouth of our ancestors for the time being, until the other teeth had worn out. Wisdom teeth stopped ancient man from starving to death because of such a nuisance as a cavity or a too hard nut. Today's food is much softer, and we have all kinds of appliances to grind it. We don't need wisdom teeth anymore because the rest of our teeth last much longer. So if you've had your jaw x-rayed and already know for sure that you don't have wisdom teeth, congratulations! You have entered the next stage of evolution. Fact number three, our immune system has improved tremendously. In 2007, a group of scientists from London studied about 1,800 new genes that have appeared in humans over the past 40,000 years. Most of these genes are related to people's ability to fight diseases. Scientists have found that people living on the African continent have 12 new genes that help the body to fight malaria. And the inhabitants of large cities are equipped with genes to fight tuberculosis and leprosy. Thus, our birthplace affects our immune system. Fact number four, our brains are shrinking. Over the past 30,000 years, the average human brain has shrunk from 1,500 to 1,350 cubic centimeters. The difference is about the size of a tennis ball. Scientists have several theories about this. The first is that we are becoming dumber. The reason for this is the high standard of living and the complex organization of society. Simply put, you don't have to be very smart to survive. Another theory is that small brains are much more efficient than big brains because links between nerve cells are made much faster, and this allows us to think faster. Finally, there is a theory that states that a smaller brain makes us look better, giving us an advantage in our social life. Fact number five, some of us have blue eyes. In theory, all of us should have brown eyes. But 100,000 years ago, somewhere around the Black Sea, there was a mutation that gave our eyes a blue color. Why it survived remains a mystery. After all, as you probably remember from your biology course, or maybe you're just about to study it, the brown eye gene is dominant and the blue eye gene is recessive, which means that it has to work very hard to win. Nevertheless, blue eyes are not uncommon these days. The gene is really determined to survive. What's more, it programs its owners. A 2007 study showed that blue-eyed men and women find people with the same blue eyes more attractive. Brown-eyed people, on the other hand, don't care about the eye color of their potential partners. By the way, evolution is not planning on stopping. We are still adapting to the new realities of life, but it's all happening very slowly, from one generation to the next, without you noticing it. Perhaps in 2,000 years, humans will look very different. For example, our thumbs may become 3 times longer, so they can reach all corners of those giant modern smartphones and write even more angry comments online. But we are not talking about you, friends. Tony and I think you are the best followers out there. By the way, tell us in the comments what you think people will look like in the future. The best ideas will be featured in the next video. See you in the next and exciting episode of Super Tony. Bye-bye.